If there is a time for everything, is it time for God to be in your everything? Good morning, everyone. This is our reflection question for today. Today's first reading from Ecclesiastes reminds us that there is a time for everything. Part of a longer passage that dwells on death, it speaks of life as a spectrum of happiness and sadness, contentment and torment. These passages were written into a song that became a number one hit song, Turn, 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 in 1965, that can still be heard on the airwaves today. We have no control of many things, nor influence the movement of the universe or determine completely what events will become. But as much as we can control, we must do what we can to help ourselves become what God wants us to be. As my favorite motto says, just do your best and let God take care of the rest. The book of Luke mentions a number of times Jesus' secret to success as he follows his Father's will. This is mentioned in today's gospel. He does this every day, especially before important events in his life. That is, to pray, and to pray alone, firmly locked in a huddle with his Father, impervious to his surroundings. As we do what is humanly possible to turn things our way and fulfill God's will for us in the process, we must always surrender our plans to God. We must always be careful in reacting to situations without first seeking the guidance of the Holy Spirit, which Jesus says will be our guide when he goes away. We may act in ways that may even cause more problems, which God did not intend us to have if we only sought his guidance. In the local parlance, we are warned not to act hastily, huwag padalos-dalos. That is why the best time to pray is during the early hours of the morning, where there are no distractions, where you can listen intently and reflect on God's word attentively. Jesus models this in Mark chapter 1, verse 35. Very early the next morning, long before daylight, Jesus got up and left the house. He went out of town to a lonely place where he prayed. When consulting the Holy Spirit before we act, we can avoid harm and bring blessings to ourselves and those around us. Otherwise, we may be led by that absolute deceptive evildoer himself to be selfish and so self-centered to do others wrong through our uncontrolled anger and resentment, unforgiveness and lies, hasty judgment and harsh words. He deceives us by making us so busy with mundane things that we can even forget to consult our Lord in every aspect of our lives. Procrastinating to pray, postponing to do our spiritual acts, including asking our Mama Mary's intercession through the Holy Rosary, and going to Mass daily in the virtual during this pandemic, is his way to distract us from consulting God. We must be assured that in everything, God is in control. It is up to us to give him the driver's seat to bring us to his destination safely. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, instill in me the urge and the discipline to pray devoutly, daily, without distractions, with joyful anticipation. This I pray in Jesus' holy and mighty name. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers and sisters. God bless our Catholic faith and couples for Christ.